वेलकम टू दिस 37th सेशन ऑफ एर्गोनॉमिक्स फॉर बिगिनर्स इंडस्ट्रियल डिजाइन पर्सपेक्टिव। नाउ द करेंट मॉड्यूल इज मॉड्यूल नंबर 9, परफॉर्मेंस सपोर्ट एंड डिजाइन इंटरवेंशन। आउट ऑफ 5 क्लासेस हियर, टुडेज द करेंट सेशन इज अ क्लास नंबर 37, द फर्नीचर सपोर्ट रिलेटेड। द जिस्ट ऑफ लास्ट सेशन व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड, जस्ट टू रिकॉल, वर्क स्टेशन और वर्क स्पेस इशू एंड डिजाइन इंटरवेंशन। व्हाइल टेकिंग एनी डेवलपमेंट स्टेप, इट रिक्वायर्स टू कैरी आउट ergonomic assessments. Persons' abilities and job demands specific to unorganized work environment. It is necessary and it was stressed. System approach to be taken for design intervention, even to develop a single product. Need for adoption of specific design development strategy, whether it is employees requirement based or employers supply based. Office ergonomics relevant to workstation and workplace design, and office ergonomics issues which we have discussed. The discussion concluded with an design ideation approach, taking counter as an example that modifies user's behavior. So we have concluded last session with the mention that design can modify user's behavior. So, with this background, today's session is class 37, furniture support and relevant design ideation issues and some exercises we are going to discuss now. Now, the ideation or innovation, the issues and some issues along with ergonomic principles in design development, that we are, it constitutes today's session. Innovation meets the need with value addition. Now, in this figure, the person, the peer group or the friends, they are using some furniture, but it is not the regular way of using it. Now, the question comes, if this behavior or this meeting arrangement is necessary, then what could be the design support? And that design support should fulfill some basic criteria, that space constraints and the user's compatibility features. So, it would be better to see if those design can be stackable, and like here in this figure it is shown that how it can be made in a stackable design development. Now, the some design concepts addressing context specific issues, what we need to consider. The design is an innovative, practical, reproducible solution to conceive various aids to human needs. it is a continuous problem solving process with conversion of ideas into reality, keeping in mind the user's characteristics and limitations, art and aesthetics, material and process, and new technology applications in consideration. So now, good design does follow human inbuilt as well as acquired abilities and limitations in terms of physical, physiological and behavioral aspects. New attempts are being made by designers exploring local eco-friendly material. Application of ergonomics principles would yield better result. Like here, some of the furniture being like cane and bamboo items that has already been developed at the Department of Design IIT Guwahati through faculty initiatives. These are very good looking, but when the ergonomics principles are considered, the design would be better and people will accept it with trust and reliability of using that, it would also be there. So, in this session, we shall discuss about the few body support and function relevant design, that is the ideation issues. Now, when here we will be discussing some of the design relevant matter, so the ergonomic principles, that is the reference basic principles, the reference to be taken as discussed in earlier sessions. Just for as for example, we can say that like session number 18, where the parallel relation between trunk and lower leg etcetera was discussed. So, like that some other principles related to the human compatibility, that issues to be taken or referred, the material we have already discussed earlier classes. Now, we are present showing some of the design ideation examples. Now, here the four design ideation exercises we are going to discuss now that satisfy specific requirements. Now, these exercises are number 1, a multipurpose hostel table, number 2, mobile lecture delivery assistive trolley, number 3, a student's classroom drawing table with seat stand facility, and 4, a school classroom seat desk furniture. These four exercises we will be discussing now. An exercise to make a simple multipurpose hostel table. It was developed for hostel rooms purpose where much space is not available. So, the issues behind the feature selection was it should be simple design, easy to make and repair. Special space allocation is not necessary. Anywhere in the room it can be placed. Fits even computer work for single person use as well as a friend also may join in that same table to share their ideas and views and work in that same computer also. The various featured computer workstations are available in market. This study examined if these features are really necessary or not. Here, this was developed, or we can say that this was conceived, this design the simplicity in design. A table that can also be used as personal computer work table. Here, all the anthropometric dimensions like different work zones, primary work zone, secondary work zone and others, and the height of the as per human body anthropometry, this design was conceived. And the legs and etcetera were put inside so that while crossing, the person's leg should not hit the furniture leg, etcetera. And in the lower plate is presented in such a way that it can be used as footrest as well as material keeping like that. So, the optimum use of human resources to maximum output that was considered here, fitting task and design to man in work and rest. These were the basic thought behind conceiving this idea or this design. The simple concept of a table with two layer platform, the top one to be used as main work surface and bottom one for other storage as well as can also be used as footrest. The product dimensions follow the ease of user's body parts movement while work with computer. Now, it can be said that whatever computer workstations are available in market, it has many compartments. Mostly it is seen that one table top where the computer monitor etcetera can be placed, and below that a small drawer is there that it can be pulled out and pushed in. That type of drawer is there where the keyboards may be placed, and then CPU and etcetera it may be placed either on the side, on any side below the table top. So, these are the normally this is the basic structure. Now, when we work, it seems that when we use the mouse movement space is required, but normally that under drawer, the drawer under the table platform, it does not give that much scope to move freely the mouse. So, what happens? Mouse, the hand remains almost in a static position to operate that mouse. And also the layer, the one layer where the mouse and typing is going on, and then another layer where the computer monitor and other reference materials are there, that also we are touching. So, the multi layer is there. So, instead of all the things, and also when you have a drawer type of keyboards keeping space, there the arm remains in a hanging position. So, some other physical body problems it appears. So, to avoid all the things, a small study was done, and it is found that a single table top would be good for all type of things. Even nowadays, as per development of laptop computers and etcetera, that computer workstation whatever is available in market, there is time has come to relook into the requirements of all those things. Just with this it is seen that now here it is seen that how it can be used to the below the UPS or maybe that CPU and then the computer monitor here it can be operated. So, a single person on this any chair can be placed, one person can operate, even both persons also can operate with the same thing. So, like that these are the concepts. So, with this concept it can be said that a single table top would be good for hostel purpose, where the first top level will be for used as a table top and the bottom one will be as a material keeping platform as well as for to be used as a footrest. Now, the second exercise, a design exercise, that is mobile lecture delivery assistive trolley. The need is that it is observed when a person delivers lecture in a classroom, in a large classroom, he prefers to move from one end to other end of the dais. And while moving, now if in a corner of a dais, if that computer or some other mic and etcetera are placed, then it restricts his movement. But while delivering some lecture, the body gesture posture, it also adds to the topic he is delivering through verbal message. So, to fulfill this need, what was done? A sleek mobile lecture delivery assistance device was felt to develop. Now, what was the facilities to be there? With computer etcetera, modern facilities will be there to suit ceiling mounted LCD projection. Means LCD projection will be some the ceiling mounted, but the lecturer, the who is delivering the lecture, he can move on the at the floor on the dais. Inbuilt multiple power points to be there, 4 rotating wheels with supports, with stoppers will be there, so that he can move around with that, and 4 wheels, rotating wheels, so that it can have free movement. The foot rest, because while delivering some lecture or some work, doing some work, people prefer to use that foot rest even in a standing position. Push pull horizontal handle etcetera features have been considered. Now, mobile on the dais lecture delivery assistance with organic look was given. All the straight lines and sharp corners, it gives a very hard look. So, if we have a free flow some form like organic form, it invites, it gives a pleasing look. So, with that a concept was developed in it was like this. Here what has happened, the table top, this portion is a computer area, maybe monitor, small monitor or laptop monitor, laptop. Now, here the 4 wheels are there, 4 legs, it is a carved, this is a CPU, if it is necessary to use or maybe some other things can be placed. Here with this type of leg, here one can keep their leg while standing. Now, on this people can lean and can move over the dais. Now, this is from the front, this side is that lecturer's side and opposite side is the classroom side. Here this platform can be pulled out like this if it is necessary to use as a writing platform, it can be pulled out. And then if it is, then this is a drawer where some other material like remote controls and etcetera, paper, pen, pencils like that, it can be stored, and this place is free. Now, if you pull out and after delivering lecture, all the material keep it here and then just pull this cover and then make a lock here. So, everything will be locked. And then on this, the sides, there were some plug points and etcetera, so that with only one plug point, that gives here a multi plug connection, so that it can be used. Even on this head, here mic also can be fitted. So, these are the some concepts were developed. But now, the actual product, it looks like this. this is the audience side and this is the lecturer's instructor side. Now here the symbol of the or the whatever the classes going on in etc. that may be placed in this area. This handle can be used for rolling, and this with only one wire there is a connection to multi connection here, so that from here whatever required it can be plugged in. So these are the issues. Now here what's happened? This platform, the lower, the below the main table top, it can be pulled out slow little bit to use it as an extended table, and if you pull it more then it can fold and it can be used as a locking device. So view from left to right, the product rotation takes place in a clockwise movement. So this is the if product was developed. Now another area, a student's classroom. Student classroom drawing table with sheet stand facility, a design ideation exercise. And the basic principle is that when a person draws, normally when they draw some mechanical engineering drawing, that type of drawings and others, normally people prefer to stand and draw. But for a longer time, standing is also a problem, and if a person sits, it also does not give much comfort for that use. So considering all these things, it was decided if a sheet stand device can also be included with that. So the concept of a hip rest design may be used in such a context where either long duration sitting or standing is not necessary. So this type of hip stand. So with this basic principle, how a design can be developed? Here one design development is being shown and another design development also follows. Like a stool can be developed, it was developed a multi-purpose sitting device where the three tying rods of these three legs are in different heights. A stool with three different height tying members, these tying members are used as structural strength as well as foot rests for sitting with full foot rest using the highest one. If a person sits here, the top one, the highest one, can be used as a foot rest, and while standing, this the lowest foot tying member can be used for normal foot rest in a standing position. And if a person has this type of feature, this type of posture while delivering some lecture or some or maybe some other activities, then the middle one can be used for a semi like this. This design also supports a semi standing posture by using the middle and the lowest ones. So a high seat with hip rest concept was developed. It can be used in different contexts and different places. Now in the student classroom, it is found that this type of tables and chairs are normally used to make occasional use of a pedestal stool in standing work, that is hip rest, whether we can use it or not in this context. Now at IIT Guwahati Mechanical Engineering Design Drawing Studio, a small study was carried out just to see that how the students use the existing designs. Now the designs were simple like this, and problem faced by students that uncomfortable posture because the height is too low, the table cannot be accessed well in sitting, students need to move around the table to access the drawing board completely, to use the total whole drawing board they have to move around, inadequate height of the table requires students to work in an uncomfortable bending posture like this. The figure alongside shows the average dimensions of the existing engineering drawing table in three different views. It obvious it is 80 and 58 centimeter from the front, 72 and 58 7.5 centimeter height, and from the side the table height was the table height has been observed to be inadequate for most users. The inclination of the table, there is a two fold inclination is here. So, the inclination is also insufficient to provide proper access of the entire board. So, with this the concept was taken like this. Here what happened, the whole structure, this right hand side, the left hand side is the table with a Z line, Z type of structure. So, it gives a sleek look, where the basic frame structure and etcetera is given like this, as that the total frame on the square frame like this, in a square frame the normal drawing board is placed. So, the frame width is 50 centimeter, frame length is 60, the frame depth is 17 like that, and normal drawing board is being used. Now, here the height, this is the triangular area, this is a circle movement is this, and then the height of this area was this height from the floor, this was kept only within 4 centimeter, because while walking without getting any tension on the thigh muscles, we normally lift our leg at around 4 to 5 centimeter. So, if it is kept at that level, so while walking or while crossing over this, it would not hit, a leg would not hit this structure. So, by that way all the dimensions was considered. And now, here what happened, with that the three level of mechanical point was given, so that at three different levels it can be operated. So, means horizontal and maximum the 30 degree, and in between two other positions are kept. And the tool was developed like this, where here one can you have this as a foot rest. If he sits here, or can be used if he stand also here, if he stand then a back leg he can keep like this way. So, these were the development. So, engineering drawing table with stool, a specialized stool development was developed. Now, units arranged in a hall, like tabletop and then seat like this way. Working wise, the possibility that units are in use. This area is used as a foot rest. So, the front foot rest as well as backward here also it can be used as a back foot rest, and when it is not used it may be used for a larger papers can also be kept it here when the foot rest it is not used as foot rest. The top was given a single bending, the top is bent used in angles as required. So, as required the students can change modify the bendings, the angles. Now, the fourth development, a school classroom seat desk furniture, a context specific design. First, the common disadvantages faced with some existing school furniture was studied, like here how they use summer, how they feel with the features, with the double layered table top, what are the problem, the leg room problem, if they sit then going in and coming out, that problem, the book keeping and etc. it is a problem here, like this. And as this is supposed to be used as a armrest, but it does not provide that armrest, as well as it restricts free going in and coming out. Now, if the furniture does not match with the student, what happens? Now, this type of furniture, if it is there, then to take out some material from the lower platform is a difficulty, like this. And then, so these are the some of the problem areas where this was noticed. And then, how these problem areas can be considered in a new furniture design, that we have to see it. Now, the design development of a new seat desk unit suitable for Indian school children, first we have to done the growth pattern study. Now, with this it is found that till 10th year, we do not require any anthropometric dimension variation wise different furniture, different school stool, seat and desk units. In the higher studies classes, still it is found that the furniture is not necessary to be different with male and female. So, the criteria considered: one, unisex design; second, seating for 2 persons, so that if in a seat 3 persons seats, then the 2 side persons they are getting freedom, but the centered one finds problem. So, we decided that it seating for 2 persons, seat desk combined unit. Why we have decided that it will be combined unit? Because in a school environment, if chair, if a seat and desk is always separate, then it is a to maintain a specific position is difficult. So, we decided that seat desk combined unit. Design confirms users behavior, because students, what is their behavior, they may jump with or whatever on that furniture and how they behave. So, the where the strength and etcetera to be given in that structure. Users body geometry and design dimension match. Short duration books and other belonging storage is necessary. Easy in and out to and comfortable use. 3 different sizes were developed. Three sizes for age group: number 1, 6 to 8 years, that is first to third standard; second level, 9 to 12 and 13 years, so that is third to seventh standard; and third development, that 12 to 13 to 16 years, that is 7 to 10th standard, as per age and standard of study respectively. Storage space at seat side was considered. Now, then we can say that, so the dimensions was considered here. And the what are the anthropometric dimensions was considered mentioned here. And now, in this right hand corner drawing, it says that if this is the chair unit, this is the chair unit, then length, breadth and all dimensions were considered as the children anthropometric dimensions specific to Indian context. The data reference was taken from ergonomics activities, ergonomics laboratory of Industrial Design Center, IIT Bombay. Professor G.G. Ray has conducted a study on that children anthropometry, and the data was taken from that. Now, the if it is a joint unit, then chair and the table has to be separated. If it is a separate unit, then chair and this is the table unit. So, it is considered. So, based on this, The next step was that where the book etcetera storage space should be. For that study was done that if the this blue part is the storage area. Now, if it is below the table top, then there is a problem that we found earlier. Now, if we keep at the outside or the distance side of the table, then to take out is a problem. Here, if it is a below the bench or seat, to collect it from that is also a problem. Then, if it is a triangular desk type, means the cover opens up, the problem is that when the this person is writing and this person wishes to open, then it is a problem. Or to open this, the top has to be cleared, then only it can be opened, that is a problem. Then it comes, if we can have on the table tops both the sides. If it is both the sides, then what happens? The main writing table top reduces in size. Then only way is that if we can have a little larger table size and the sheet with the side storage places and that length and this table length remains same, then it would be possible. Means this is the table, this is the bench, and then this is the thing. So, this will remain within the same distance. So, these units we can make in a row like this way, in a row like this way. This is table and this is student. This is the table and this is the bench. This is a table and this is the bench kind of thing. So, a row may be maintained in a classroom. While making the models, during prototype making throughout trial was given, which results in a design that invites children to use it. So, different size and nature of students were considered for trials, and then while making these trials were made. So, the what would be the angle of this thing and what would be the height, what would be the length etcetera was considered here. Basically, then this height was kept within 4 centimeters, because you can go and come in easily. So, here one consideration was that the clearance, so that while sitting he can stand up, can come out and go in, as well as he can read and write with a bending without any problem. A, between seat and work surface requires comfort while entering, sitting and working in a loom. B, trials being conducted while designing a single framed seat and table unit for school children's use, which requires occasionally standing and also provides easiness in getting in and out. With this, this is the final product developed. Now, here only one set of product we are showing, that is a new seat desk device, the prototype for age group 6 to 8 years, first to third standard, it was shown, it is being shown here, and other total 3 was developed, and then other 2, the total was 3, so other 2 have different dimensions. Now, here the facilities is that this is a 5 degree inward inclination, easier to write and read. This is the basic structure of the sideways tray. The bottom has a porous plate where the if any liquid matter is fall here, then it may go out. And this is a rod, and it is so strong, and it is little higher than the floor, so that cleaning would be easier. And then this rod is made in such a way that if someone jumps on it or sit on it, there will be no problem. This is little higher and this in the back side is little lower, because when you extend leg forward and use it as a foot rest, then you require little higher height, and then when backward it requires lower height, So that and all the dimensions were considered with the children anthropometry. That is told that I just now mentioned that from IDC Bombay the initial data was taken, and then IIT Guwahati has conducted another study to get the reliability of the total information that can be used for this design development. Now here with this then there is a hook from this table top, so that the water bottles etcetera can be hanged on this, so that you do not require to go always to somewhere to get water, or you do not need to keep the water bottle etcetera on the table top itself. Then another thing comes, mostly what happens in a, this is considered that in a classroom, the all the walls will have some almirah type of racks, where main bag, books etcetera will be kept there, and for each and every class requirement wise, the material, books and papers etcetera to be collected and to be kept here for that specific class, or maybe one two classes together. For map or some drawing type of classes, where you require additional storage of the large papers and etcetera, for that these two floating things have been provided, so that it will be kept at the wall side, so when it is necessary it will be taken from that and will be kept it here. So it will maintain a straight line, so it will not, so a total unit it will be there. So with this now we can say that the dimensions follows children's body dimensions and behavior pattern, helps maintaining sitting column and row in a classroom, because like this it will develop like this, so units can be kept like this. Hook for like here, this hook is kept here, this hook is for hanging water bottle etcetera. These are the two floating additional storage bin in the front, may also be used. So the total length of this was at 115 centimeter, total height was 60 centimeter, and total this length of this was 75 centimeter, and total depth of the total unit was 90 centimeter. So this was developed on for age group of 6 to 8 years first to third standard, and two other variations having larger or specific body dimensions. This was now with this we can the after making the final product also, it was kept in a school for many few days, children used it, and then we got their feedback, and finally and the different size to children they see it. Now question comes, we have developed the three different sizes in a classroom. The front rows will have the furnitures meant for that class age group wise, there may be some taller sizes people, so the next level of furniture can be placed at the rear. If there is some smaller size children are there, then the below level furniture may be kept at the beginning few, like that a classroom management can be considered, and that also influenced by the design development of a furniture. But while developing this furniture, it's only a total system design approach was taken the way it is discussed right now. So with this it can be said that with this figure, can we think a design intervention suitable to this context? That is up to you, how you are looking at your surroundings and you are identifying the need, what would be the considerations, and then accordingly give your ideas and see if it can be a it become a good design solution for that. So, whatever we discuss today, in a summary, it can be said that design development attempt must have proper need identification, followed by design ideation exercise and incorporation of context specific human compatibility and comfort issues to be considered. Similar to the above mentioned concept that we have just now seen, four concept developments, relevant need based and anticipated need based design ideation exercises may be initiated to meet our varied nature requirements. So, with this we do expect that some similar type of design ideation exercise we can take. With this we are concluding today's session of the furniture support with a specific context, and the next session would be the class number 38, that vertical arm reach and relevant design application possibility, where not only the vertical arm reach, but we will specifically stress on how a design development is possible, keeping arm movement and arm activities in consideration in a specific context. That we will see in the next day. So, till then, thank you, see you next day.